In this video, I'm going to talk about the sympathetic nervous system, which is a division of the autonomic nervous system. And we're going to talk about the motor pathways, as well as the neurotransmitters and hormones involved in this system. Now, the motor pathways consist of two neurons end-to-end, the so-called preganglionic neuron, and then the postganglionic neuron. The preganglionic neuron cell bodies are located within the CNS, more specifically in the spinal cord between T1, thoracic region number 1, through lumbar region number 2. The system can also be referred to as the thoracolumbar division. The preganglionic neuron extends out a long axon and will synapse with a cell body of a postganglionic neuron, and the postganglionic neuron will synapse with the target tissue. And of course, these target tissues can either be smooth muscle, cardiac muscle, or gland. The region where the pre- and postganglionic neurons synapse is termed a ganglia. There are two types of ganglia within the sympathetic nervous system, something called the sympathetic chain ganglia, and another type of ganglia called the collateral ganglia. The difference between these two pathways is the location of the ganglia, but mainly the difference is between the types of target tissues. In those pathways that run through the sympathetic chain ganglia and synapse there, target tissues include the eye, the heart, the airways to the lungs, and also the salivary glands. In pathways that run through the collateral ganglia and synapse here, the target tissues include the GI tract, as well as accessory organs to the digestive system, such as the liver and the pancreas, and also the bladder and genitals. Other than that, the neurotransmitters that are involved in these two pathways are exactly the same. The neurotransmitter released from the preganglionic neuron is termed acetylcholine, and the neurotransmitter released from the postganglionic neuron is termed norepinephrine. The receptors for the acetylcholine are located on the cell body and dendrites of the postganglionic neuron, and these are called nicotinic cholinergic receptors. The receptors that are located on the target tissues are all members of the same superfamily of receptors called the adrenergic receptors. Before we leave the sympathetic nervous system, I need to tell you about one more type of motor pathway. In this motor pathway, we still have a preganglionic neuron that extends an axon out into the peripheral nervous system. The cell body is still located within the spinal cord, and this is also still called the preganglionic neuron. However, instead of synapsing with another neuron, this preganglionic neuron synapses with the adrenal medulla. Now, if we take a cross-section look through the adrenal gland, we'll find it consists of two areas, a central medulla, the adrenal medulla, and the adrenal cortex. That these synapses occur with the adrenal cells within the adrenal medulla. Upon stimulation of this gland, the cells will secrete two hormones, epinephrine and norepinephrine. Because this is an endocrine gland, the two substances that are secreted will move into the blood flow and be transported around the body. When these hormones reach the target tissues, which will still be either a smooth muscle, a cardiac muscle, or a gland, they will bind to the same family of receptors, the so-called adrenergic receptors. So we have a preganglionic neuron synapsing with the adrenal medulla. Stimulation of the adrenal medulla causes release of the hormones epinephrine and norepinephrine, which will move through the blood until they reach their target tissues and bind to and activate adrenergic receptors. In terms of the neurotransmitter, the same neurotransmitter is used here, the acetylcholine, and that will still bind to the nicotinic cholinergic receptors. Of course, in this pathway, there is no ganglia here, just the synapse between a neuron and an endocrine gland. Therefore, this is called a neuroglandular junction. The other point I want to make is that because norepinephrine is released from the adrenal medulla into the blood supply, it does act as a hormone. But in the previous two diagrams where norepinephrine was released from the axon terminal of postganglionic cells, here it is functioning as a neurotransmitter.